How to assess a child for malnutrition. To find out if the malnutrition is a sign of a mild, moderate, or severe illness, you will assess the child. Identifying a child with malnutrition early and helping them get the proper care and treatment may prevent them from needing to be hospitalized or even dying. Start assessing the child by asking the caregiver a few questions. As you do this, try to find out why the child is so poorly nourished so that you can recommend the best next steps. Number one, ask about the child's nutrition. You can ask, is she breastfeeding? If so, how often and for how long? If not, has she been recently weaned off breast milk? A breastfeeding child may not be getting enough milk, or since weaning, the child may not be getting enough nutrition from foods. If she is eating foods, what type of foods and how much? Does she eat a varied diet of proteins, grains, fats, carbohydrates, fruits, vegetables, and dairy? Is there always enough nutritious food available for the child? Low amounts of food or a limited variety of foods can result in undernutrition. Is she able to feed and drink? If the child cannot feed or is not able to absorb nutrients, such as with severe diarrhea, this is a danger sign that requires an urgent referral. Number two, ask about her growth. You can ask, how has her growth changed over time compared to other children her age? Has she always been small, or was she growing normally until a particular time? What was happening around the time that this changed? Healthy children should always be growing in height or length and gaining weight. If their growth curve starts flattening out or they fall off their curve, this indicates a problem. Number three, ask how active and responsive the child is. You can ask, is she very weak, lifeless, or irritable? Any of these signs can suggest severe malnutrition, which is a danger sign. Is she able to drink liquids normally? If the child cannot drink enough to stay hydrated, it can be a severe sign. It is also more difficult to identify dehydration in a child who is malnourished. Number four, ask about deworming and vitamin A. You can ask, when was the last time the child was dewormed and received vitamin A? If a child has worms, it affects their body's ability to absorb nutrients, which can lead to malnourishment and stunting. Stunted children usually lack vitamin A, which increases their risk of blindness and death. Lastly, number five, find out if the child has other symptoms or has been sick lately. You can ask, does she have diarrhea, vomiting, a runny nose, a cough, or a fever? Is she living with HIV or does she have tuberculosis or TB? Does she have any new rashes similar to measles? An illness may prevent the body from using nutrients and can also cause the body to need more energy or calories. Has she taken or is currently taking any medications? Certain medications can affect a child's appetite or nutrient absorption. Asking these questions will help you better understand how malnourished the child is and what the possible causes could be. You will also need to look at the child to gather more information about their signs. Start by looking for signs of severe malnourishment. Is the child very round and plump in the abdomen, or do they look thin and short for their age? Check for swelling of both feet or nutritional edema. This may be due to kwashiorkor and is a danger sign. Do a mid-upper arm circumference or MOAC tape measurement for children between 6 months and 5 years to check if the child may have marasmus. Red or less than 11.5 centimeters on the MOAC tape is a danger sign. It is also important to assess the expecting and lactating mother for malnutrition, as this can affect the growing baby in the womb or during breastfeeding. It is a concern if the mother has less than 23 centimeters on their MOAC tape measurement and a body mass index of less than 18.5 centimeters. Weigh and measure the child. Check their weight and height or length measurement over time. Look for poor weight gain and a slowing of growth. If the child's growth curve flattens, drops, or crosses a line on their growth chart, this indicates a problem. Once you have completed your assessment, you can decide if the child is malnourished and if so, whether it is a sign of a mild, moderate, or severe illness. If it indicates a mild illness, you can help the caregiver treat the child at home. If it indicates a moderate illness, you will decide whether the symptoms can be treated at home or if the child needs to be referred. However, if it indicates a severe illness, you should refer the child urgently to a health facility. This process will be explained in more detail in another video. Remember that an important part of all your assessments is to make sure that the family has enough nutritious food to meet their basic needs. If they don't, refer them to a service that can help support them. This can prevent malnutrition early.